वॉचिंग स्टडी विद सुधीर। द यूनिवर्सिटी ग्रांट्स कमीशन और यूजीसी जैसा कि हम उसको बुलाते हैं हैज कम अप विद अ ग्रैंड प्रपोजल, ए बिग फैट डायनामिक गेम चेंजर ऑफ अ प्रपोजल दैट विल कंप्लीटली ऑल्टर द डायनामिक्स ऑफ द कॉम्पिटिटिव एंट्रेंस एग्जामिनेशन सिस्टम इन द कंट्री। एज अ जर्नलिस्ट इनफैक्ट इफ आई हैव टू हेडलाइन इट आई विल कॉल इट द प्लान फॉर वन नेशन वन एग्जामिनेशन। राइट, द प्लान एसेंशियली इज टू मर्ज नीट एंड जेई into CUET, CUET जो कि इसी साल पैदा हुआ है, जिसका पहला एग्जामिनेशन इस साल हुआ है, उसमें ये पुराने एग्जामिनेशन सिस्टम को मर्ज करने का प्रपोजल फ्लोट किया है यूजीसी ने। नीट में तकरीबन इस साल 18.5 लाख स्टूडेंट्स ने भाग लिया, एग्जाम लिखा। जेई हैड आई थिंक अबाउट 8-9 लाख स्टूडेंट्स एंड CUET हैड अबाउट 15 to 16 लाख स्टूडेंट्स। सो ओवरऑल आई थिंक अबाउट 43 लाख स्टूडेंट्स wrote these three big fat examinations for medical, engineering and general subject, general education under the CUET in 2022, and that makes it one big fat examination if all three of them actually come together. Now, what is the plan? Let's understand it before we get into whether it's good or bad, whether it's workable or non-workable, and most importantly ki actual motive kya hai, उसको भी समझने की कोशिश करेंगे। तो आप वीडियो के अंत तक प्लीज बने रहें, ज्यादा लंबा वीडियो नहीं रहेगा। नाउ यूजीसी चेयरपर्सन जगदीश कुमार हैज सेड दैट इंस्टेड ऑफ अपीयरिंग फॉर 4 सब्जेक्ट्स पीसीएमबी इन पर्टिकुलर इन द 3 एंट्रेंस एग्जामिनेशन, पीसीएम फॉर जेई एंड पीसीबी फॉर नीट, स्टूडेंट्स कैन टेक ओनली वन एग्जामिनेशन दैट इज सीयूईटी एंड देयरबाय बी एलिजिबल फॉर एनी स्ट्रीम टू एक्सप्लोर डिफरेंट कोर्सेस। ओके, so for example if a student's score is not good enough to qualify for NEET, okay, either the student can take a drop or the student has the option to pursue a BSc degree from, let's say, any college in Delhi University, BSc physics honors, BSc chemistry honors, BSc zoology honors, whatever, right? उसके लिए एक अलग CUET का एग्जाम लिखने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी। इन एडिशन टू नीट, सेम एग्जामिनेशन में नीट भी आ जाएगा, CUET में, दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी में कोई कॉलेज में दाखिला भी हो सकता है। सो द आइडिया इज दैट यू डोंट नीड टू गो इन फॉर डिफरेंट एग्जामिनेशन, एक एग्जाम लिखो, सारा मामला उसी में तय हो जाएगा। दैट इज द प्लान। ओके, द प्लान इज ऑल्सो टू कंडक्ट ट्वाइस अ ईयर, वंस इन डिसंबर एंड वंस द सेकंड टाइम आफ्टर द स्कूल बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन। ओके, now the UGC has proposed a committee which will discuss with different stakeholders to reach a consensus. yahan tak to baat theek hai. now let's examine it, aur mere paas 5-6 point hai batane ke liye. pehli baat, and this is important, I personally see this as a trial balloon. isko journalistic parlance mein hum trial balloon kehte hain, or as my friend Kapil Gupta of neetprep.com said, this is a fishing expedition. basically what the UGC is trying to do is to put out this proposal in the public domain to see how the different stakeholders react to it. and who are the stakeholders? holders, the Medical Council of India, the IITs, the students, the parents, the coaching institutes, the educators, right? which is not bad, because obviously before you take a big decision, it's important to know how the public is likely to react to something like this, because this is a big game changer of a proposal, right? but the second question is, IITs are autonomous organizations, and as my friend Peri Maheshwar of Careers 360 pointed out, they are not regulated by the UGC. so is the UGC trying to take some kind of territorial control, ki even the IITs come under it and UGC becomes like some big daddy of the Indian education system, right? because as Maheshwar also pointed out another important aspect, and this is important because even though the NTA conducts the JEE Mains, the JEE Advanced is conducted by the IITs themselves, right? so the final call in a sense is taken by the IITs on who will take a, get admission into the different IITs, the older ones as well as the newer ones in the country. so will they give up that right? I have my doubts. third point, NEET ko lekar abhi bhi kafi sara controversy chalta aa raha hai. you go to a state like Tamil Nadu, they are still opposed to NEET. they do not want an examination like the NEET, which they say is anti poor student, right? so you are planning to replace one NEET with a CUET examination. you're only changing the acronym, you're not changing the basic character of the examination. jo concerns hai usko address karne ki koshish nahi ki ja rahi hai, right? so the concerns of states like Tamil Nadu will continue to be there. they will be opposed to this kind of a system to select our medical students in the country, right? What will also happen is that a big fat CUET will also mean a bigger and a fatter coaching institute industry. Dummy schools will continue to flourish. School system in 11th and 12th will be completely smashed and destroyed because students and parents will not take the school system seriously jab uska koi fayda hi nahi hai. Sab kuch IITs, medical college, Delhi University, Banaras Hindu University, koi bhi university ho, if that is going to be decided by this examination, fir wo school mein mark lene ka fayda kya hoga? So the school system, they will only ensure that they go to school, get the basic minimum, but focus should be on the CUET agar this umbrella big fat examination ka proposal accept hota hai to. Okay, chautha point, how will they decide the toughness quotient of a JEE or a NEET? What I mean to say is, suppose I have to apply only to say BSc honors, BSc botany honors in a college in Delhi University, let's say Hindu college in Delhi University, do I still need to appear for the biology examination of the toughness quotient of a NEET? Because NEET mein jitna tough biology ka exam aayega, utna CUET mein botany honors ya zoology honors ya biochemistry honors ke liye utna tough paper nahi aayega. Okay, to main kis tarah ka exam dunga, kya alag alag star ke examination honge? So what you are going to have is permutations and combinations of so much of variety that IPL ka schedule iske mukable mein aasan lagega. That it will feel like, you know, it's going to be extremely confusing for a student ki main kahan pe kaun sa examination, kaun sa domain subject, kaun se college ke liye select karu. Okay, so it's going to be confusing. Students and parents will need to be guided about this. Last point, and this is my guess, that see, UGC in 2022 has not been able to convince many state universities to accept the CUET score. There are many state universities which are conducting their own examination. Only the central universities have gone ahead and accepting and want to accept, will be accepting the CUET score, right? Now, if JEE plus NEET plus CUET ka proposal accept ho jata hai, so it will put pressure on lots of state universities ki aap bhi isme jud jaiye. So is this an attempt, and I'm only asking this question, is this an attempt by CUET to become like the big examination, the main examination in the country? ताकि हर कॉलेज, हर यूनिवर्सिटी, मध्य प्रदेश में हो, कर्नाटक में हो, आंध्र प्रदेश में हो, या तमिलनाडु में हो, या बंगाल में हो, everybody will have to come and fall in line and accept the CUET score. Is this another way of putting pressure on different state universities? I don't know. I am just raising the question. Lastly, I have an appeal to the authorities who take all these decisions on behalf of all the students in the country. Please do not implement it right now in 2023, because students, especially those who have decided to drop a year for NEET or for JEE, have already started preparing according to the old system. Abhi aap systemic changes layenge to confusion hoga. They will spend too much time trying to understand the system instead of focusing on their physics, chemistry, maths and biology, right? You cannot change the rules 1 or 2 or 3 months before and expect students sabko samajh mein aa jayega. Nahi hota hai, JEE aur NEET vagara ke liye 1-2 saal ki mehnat lagti hai, right? And I'm sure you understand that. So let's not treat students like lab rats. Okay, pichle 2 saal covid ki wajah se kafi laboratory rats ki tarah experiment kafi kar chuka hai system in bachchon ke saath. Abhi fir se mat kijiye. Be very sure, give enough time so that the next batch can actually be better prepared for something like this. Give good enough time of 9 months to a year for students and educators to understand what the system is and accordingly guide the students. Okay, don't kind of push it on them 1 or 2 months before the due date. December mein exam kara rahe hain to October mein announce karke karenge to unnecessarily confusion hoga. It will only lead to stress and unnecessary tension. That's all I had to say. Please write in your comments on what you think of it, right? These were my points on the table. Thank you very much for watching. We will be observing closely as to what are the changes that take place in the entire competitive entrance examination system. God bless you. Thank you.